Okay, can you hear me okay? Ron, can you hear me okay? Can you see me?
Hello.
Can you see me and hear me?
Yes.
Okay, thank you so much for doing this. I appreciate it. I guess what can you tell me about Morgan? I know, and I was listening to an interview that he was very popular at doing funerals because he was real down to earth.
Morgan has been a good friend of mine for well over a decade and a colleague at two different churches. He had a real passion for the church, for music. For people. He had a John on the phone earlier that it was kind of a second career for him. He went to seminary in his 50s and was ordained after he earned a Master of Divinity. And he just, it was an incredible asset to the church. He was a grief counselor. He did a lot of funerals, both for members of the congregation, but also members of the community. He was just a constant presence, a leader in the Emmaus community, which is an interdenominational group that's very large. He was their spiritual director for a long time. He's going to be missed by so many people.
And he said, I talked to his hairstylist, who's a childhood friend, and said that she saw him on August 1st and he seemed fine. And by August 7th, he was in the hospital, and he said he just went downhill from there.
He was having symptoms positive by around August 3rd, and then by August 7th was in the hospital, and it just was never good from the time he was hospitalized. It was kind of a downhill trajectory. We were hopeful, of course, and lots and lots of people praying for him and expecting him to get better, but it really was a struggle.
And you were telling me that he did lots of funerals, like hundreds of funerals, and telling about the ministry that he had. You there?
Literally hundreds. I think he was an ordained minister for about 8 or 10 years, maybe. He made it known to all of the funeral homes here, particularly Memorial Park, but Memphis Funeral Home, Collierville Funeral Home, that when a family had a death and they had no connection to a church, no available minister, just call on Morgan, and he would come and meet them and find out about the deceased and write a eulogy and a funeral service. And he did that. Sometimes it would be two or three times a week for people he didn't know, which is incredible for a member of your congregation and somebody you know a lot about. But Morgan was able to do that for strangers and make it feel like he was their pastor.
And did he say about any kind of increase or you with COVID that they could do more funerals, or did you even look at it that way?
Yeah, probably a slight increase over the last year because of COVID, but he was already in demand before that. He's been doing that. He's been here 4.5 years, and he he'd been doing funerals for the community.
And he had a great story too, that he found his long lost half brother. And I watched the video of them singing together on Robinson's show. What did that mean to him to finally meet his brother?
Oh, well, it was an incredible story, and it meant so much to him. And they were so much alike. They had so much in common. When I first met his brother, after hearing the story, music, are both talented singers, songwriters, people, they love people. Sort of a chance conversation led him to a link to this potential half brother, and it turned out it was his half brother, and that it really meant a lot to Morgan to find him. They've been great friends since they connected.
Yeah, And it was a cousin that worked with him, or you found out his cousin worked with him, or if he knew his cousin, he didn't know that he knew his cousin.
I'm sorry, you froze for the first part of that.
Yeah, how did it come about? He met the cousin?
Yes, he met a cousin here in town, Philip Hamilton, who he didn't know he was his cousin until they started talking about the town where their families both originated from. Morgan was adopted. And it turns out he knew his birth parents. Much later, not when he was a young child, but with Philip, they discovered they had this town in common. And the next thing he knew, they had a relative in common, his biological father. And that's how he found his brother in Alabama, through that connection.
And you said that he worked with you at both churches. I'm sure, like you said, this is such a great loss to the church and to the community.
Oh, absolutely. We worked together at Lindenwood Christian Church in Midtown Men shortly, a couple years after he followed me out to Collierville so that we could work together again. He's also going to be missed at the former Decatur Trinity Christian Church, now known as Trinity Christian Church in Bartlett. They have one pastor, a solo pastor, and when he needed to be off, Morgan was a regular fill-in there, and they loved him there. So it's not just our church that's grieving and beyond.
And like you said, he was someone who decided a little bit later than most that he was called to the ministry.
In his 50s, early 50s, but he'd actually been doing non-ordained ministry stuff for a long time prior to that. He was an active volunteer at Lindenwood. He was an elder at Lindenwood. And it would just seem the natural progression to a lot of people who knew him when he came to my office and started talking about seminary and ordained ministry. And we literally walked seminary. It seemed so natural. Everybody knew it, that knew him, knew that the church was near and dear to his heart. And for him to be able to do that over the last several years as an ordained minister has been very meaningful.
And do you know anything about funeral arrangements yet or anything like that? Or is it too soon?
No, we will be announcing that by the end of the weekend. There will be a memorial service, have perhaps an outside memorial service as well that people can attend and be socially distanced. We have an amphitheater on our property, and Morgan was instrumental in getting concerts and other events and sometimes outdoor weddings at this amphitheater. He really loved it, and he's done a lot of work on it in the last couple of years. And so we're hoping that we can have, there may be some private smaller things, but we're hoping to have a memorial service that a lot of people can come to outside.
And you froze up for a second. Where is that amphitheater?
It's here at Collierville Christian Church on our grounds.
Oh, okay. Anything else you want to add about him?
Just that he was a fun-loving, talented, funny, great friend to everybody that knew him. And there were a lot of people in this part of Tennessee who knew him, and they count him among their.
You froze up again.
I was just saying that he was a friend to people he met. You became friends with him quickly. And he'll be missed by everybody that knew him.
And would you have a couple of pictures that you could text me of him, you know, either in the church or with you, or just to the number that you sent your address to?
Yes.
Okay. And do you go by pastor? Or
I can either text or email that, but I can text some from my phone too, probably.
Okay, yeah, text or email, that's fine. Either one, you can do it. And do you go by pastor, Pastor Buck?
Or Reverend.
Reverend, okay. My father was a minister.
So. Yeah, or just Ron Buck is fine. But I am ordained. I'm Reverend, and
Reverend. Okay.
I have a doctorate. A lot of people call me Dr. Buck, but it whatever is fine.
Okay. All right. Thank you so much for your time. I appreciate it.
In minutes, I'll get those photos right away.
Thank you. Thank you so much. Have a good day.
Oh, you too. Thank you. Bye bye.